Explosive fire made even more dangerous by hydrants that did not work. And listen to this. It's the second time just this week crews faced the very same danger. Now families are scared. Team 4's Paul Van Osdahl is taking action to see what is going on.
Early this morning, this house burned. And just a week ago, the one right next door. And in both cases, firefighters say they could not get enough water from this fire hydrant right here on the corner.
As flames roared through the house on Friendship Street, firefighters struggled to tap into two hydrants nearby.
We've lost a lot of water pressure on several hydrants. We had to call in multiple tankers to shuttle water back and forth to keep water supply.
Neighbors feared their houses could go up next. They could not believe what they saw.
My garden hose put out more high pressures than that did.
When I come out the door, I felt the heat. That's how engulfed it was, and they still didn't have no water yet.
How much of a concern is that for you?
Very big concern, because the whole neighborhood could have went up.
They had the same concern earlier this month when the house next door caught fire and firefighters could not get enough pressure from hydrants.
There was no water flow. They had to bring tankers.
The city manager says water crews checked the hydrants after both fires and the pressure appeared fine, but they did not measure the actual water flow.
You don't know what the readings are.
No, we're going to get the readings. I'm going to try to get a flow meter today and get the readings, yeah.
Last year, Team 4 found up to 20% of hydrants in some area communities have poor water pressure. And many communities don't even measure the pressure.
They need to fix all these hydrants.
Investigators from the fire marshal's office are planning to meet with Duquesne firefighters to find out exactly what went wrong with water pressure and what more can be done to keep this from happening again. Reporting from Duquesne, Paul Van Osdahl, Channel 4 Action News.